If that is true, if what you say is true, then what is Mayor Jennifer Cruz saying that there are still traces of oil in the shoreline of Pola? How do you explain that?
Correct. But this is what is stated by the experts who decided to recommend the termination of oil response. There is no such thing as 100% clean. We never said that there is 100% clean, ma'am. Even I myself, I'm saying there is no such thing. But there is what you call acceptably clean. So what happens to the last traces of oil that comes from the sea? This is what we call, we leave it to the forces of nature to move in order for its natural occurrence to be gone. You cannot have, even for 100 years, there will always be traces of oil. There will be, always. It's a sea, it's a passageway. There will always be traces. But you cannot dig and dig every single day in order to remove this oil. The natural occurrence due to weather condition, the sea waves, heat, rain, these are the contributory factors, according to experts, that will remove the oil.
No, I understand that, because we were also able to speak with DNR Secretary Tony Yulo Loizaga, and she did say that it's a passageway. There will always be traces of oil there.
Yes,
but I have to ask you,
and
Governor, has this been explained to the mayor of Pola in Oriental Mindoro? Have you talked to her personally?
Yes, ma'am. I have talked to her prior to the declaration. We had a very long talk. I told her, the provincial government, the national government will never abandon the province. Why? Because this is the commitment of the president to maintain. What we are only doing now is shifting from response to recovery. What does it mean, ma'am? We have 894 Coast Guard personnel deployed in the area and doing nothing anymore because there is no more oil to remove from the sea. So we are spending millions and millions of pesos for response for what? While we can use the fund to recover. That's what I explained to her several times.
But now that she has decided that she's not going to sign that document, what do you think will be the ramifications now?
There is none, ma'am. As far as we are concerned, the demobilization is finished. We remove the people deployed on the shore, on the offshore, and then we monitor on a daily basis and we update the report. If there are increases in presence of oil, then we will act accordingly. Ma'am, there are tests conducted. Even before tested, the water quality in the area has passed already. So, I only acted on the basis of the recommendation of experts. I'm no expert, ma'am. I'm not an expert.
No, understand
but
that.
But I listen to them.
That completely. But when you say now that there are no ramifications, no implications, if she doesn't sign that document, then why did you have to ask her to sign it?
Ma'am, no, ma'am. I did not call her to sign it. Let me clarify that. There are members of the incident command post. I think there are more than 20 or 30 members of the incident command post, and these people are members who are asked to join the meeting. What she is probably referring to is that during the time she was asked to sign a document for the declaration. Ma'am, let me tell you, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So these 17 people signed the document. Very clear, ma'am.
Yeah, you said a while ago that you had a lengthy conversation with Mayor Cruz. Tell us about what happened in that conversation, and why is it that in the end she still refused to sign and declare that the province is, or at least her shoreline is clear of any trace of the oil spill?
We never said that there is no trace of there is no more trace of oil. It's never in the resolution. What is stated here is resolution of joint agreement to terminate the oil spill response in Oriental Mindoro in line with the MT Princess Empress. Nothing in the document will you say that there is 100% lack of presence of oil. None. I explained to her the meaning of demobilization. The meaning of demobilization is very clear. The demobilization is not declaring that there is no more oil, even for 10000.1%. None. What we are saying is that we are only shifting the energy of government from response to recovery. Second, ma'am, what I'm saying is when you say demobilization, we are scaling down the response efforts. Instead of spending millions of pesos in response, we shift that to recovery.
Governor, there was also another point that she raised during an earlier interview, basically saying that the national government was there for Pola and can't of course, I can't say it for verbatim, I'm paraphrasing her here. National government was there for Pola, can't necessarily say the same with regard to the provincial government. How do you explain that and your action to what she stated?
Ma'am, I respect her opinion, but let the documents and the pictures and the videos and the people speak for themselves. The first responder before the national government came is us. The incident command post is headed by the governor and the PDRRMO. Water that is distributed to Polenios, all of them in the shorelines who do not have sources of water which are clean, because we found benzene in the water source. It was given by the provincial government. Initially, ma'am, I donated it personally, but later on, the provincial government assisted. The refill of all this water came from the provincial government. The masks that were used, the N95 that were used, the PPEs that were used, all provided by the provincial government. It's the provincial health office that conducted the test together with DOH. The provincial government distributed food packs for more than 4,000 families. The provincial government is the one coordinating with the national government every time they came, because the oil spill is not only for Pola. The oil spill has affected 74,000 families all over Oriental Mindoro. Mm-hmm. Lastly, all of the cabinet secretaries except for one, probably one, all the senators who came to Mindoro, even the president. It is my office that facilitated the entry and the exit, facilitated the delivery of the resources, their contribution, their assistance. No need to mention, because for me, what I have done is something that I did without necessarily showing it up to them. If she doesn't believe that I helped her, let the people speak for themselves. Why, ma'am? I should say, even the MDRRMO of Pola signed. If I am not helping them, if the provincial government is not helping them, how come that the vice mayor is always there to call me, councillors, the barangay officials? How come that I am all over the news, I'm always in Pola? But it's not only Pola, I'm repeating, that is affected, it's the entire province. I will have no more comment on that, but I did what I did because that, I think, is the best way to help Polenios and Oriental Mindoreños.
Governor, before we talk about the recovery efforts, the shift to rehabilitation and recovery efforts, I want to talk about where does the shipping company now stand? Where is it? Have you asked the shipping company to compensate victims? There was talk of that before. Where do things stand now between Oriental Mindoro and the shipping company? Go ahead, Governor.
Yes, it's very clear. That's why during the declaration of demobilization, I declared that the IOPC fund, the International Oil Compensation Fund, together with the claims office, will be paying all the victims on or before the 30th of September.
But isn't that separate and distinct from the accountability and responsibility of the shipping company?
Yes, ma'am. I don't want to divulge anything to preempt my actions, ma'am. Just wait for it.
But there will be.
Just wait for it.
Because there is a concern, Governor, and I'm sure you've heard of this, that there is a concern that you've been too lenient on the shipping company.
Just wait.
When is this going to happen?
As I have mentioned it before, when you have an accident along the road, and there is a victim in the accident, what will you do first? Find who is culpable, or bring first the victims to the hospital? Now, as you can see, the placing of my actions, I brought all the victims to normalcy. We are now moving to recovery. I am asking IOPC to give the compensation. And what do you think is the next?
You're now going
patience
to hold...
Patience is a virtue.
You're going to hold the shipping company accountable.
Just wait, ma'am.
And we're going to have to leave it at that. Do keep us posted when that happens, because we are following this issue very closely. Jomelito Dolor there, Governor of Oriental Mindoro, we really appreciate you taking time out to talk to us this noon. Maraming salamat po.
Maraming salamat po, ma'am. God bless po.